The Saguenay-Lac-Saint-Jean region is located in the middle of Quebec. With three national parks, as well as the Saguenay-St. Lawrence Marine Park, a marine protected area tucked alongside the Parc National du Fort du Saguenay, it's no surprise that adventure tourism and nature are defining features of the region. That's exactly why I'm excited to explore the place. My trip begins in the Saguenay Fjord, a spectacular 65-mile-long glacial-carved channel and one of the most dramatic landscapes in the world. We are kicking things off on the north shore of the fjord with a three-day hike along the rim to the village of Tadoussac.
As you can see, there's quite a bit of rain coming down upon us, which is a little bit unfortunate because this region is so beautiful and the fall colors are going off. We have about 13-14 kilometers of hiking to do today. We've been met up with one of the park rangers, Leonie, and she's joining us for the trail and getting some local expertise. It's gonna be a wet one, and we'll have to slog through it and endure just a little bit, but it's gonna be fun.
Here we are at the Parc National du Fjord du Saguenay. It's a nice national park because it's surrounding the fjord of the Saguenay. This fjord is really particular because Arctic whales are coming here, so you can have the chance walking the trail to see those whales down the cliff with all this beautiful landscape all over.
Although it's unfortunate the rain is obscuring the magical views that the fjord offers, I love hiking in the rain. Especially when you know you have a warm and dry cabin waiting for you at the end of the day. For me, rainy days on the trail deliver unique sounds and smells, and I find myself noticing little things that I might otherwise miss. The vegetation that thrives in the ground, or the raindrops hanging off pine needles. Yeah. Sometimes, rainy days can leave a brighter memory than even the sunniest of days.
Here's a cool map that details where we've been and a little bit of where we're going as well. The first night we started, we camped at this Refuge de Lance de la Cruz, and then we hiked about 8 kilometers to this point where we had lunch yesterday, and then finally wandered around to Refuge du Cap de la Boule. And here we've just had a spectacular place overlooking the meeting of the St. Lawrence and the Saguenay River. And now we have another 12 kilometers to hike and we'll eventually arrive in Tadoussac. I'm really excited about today actually being able to see the views of everywhere that we're actually been hiking.
With the new day, the rain clouds have begun their retreat and we're able to make steady progress on the trail. The sun really highlights how magical this time of year is. The maples, birches, beeches, and oaks have all started their colorful autumn dance. I have to concentrate on watching where I put my feet because my eyes are drawn everywhere but down.
It's nice to see it open up here. You actually see some of the beautiful trees. Man, these fall colors are spectacular out here.
Yeah, they are.
They're looking so nice.
So Tadoussac is just behind this mountain.
Gotcha.
So we're not far.
And so this is where all the waters are mixing and it's a lot of whales and sea life and stuff.
Whales come year after year because they know that's a good point to feed. So a lot of whales we have here because of that.
To put it simply, I'm astounded by the beauty of the area. I had no idea Quebec had so many landscapes like this. As we start our descent to the village of Tadoussac, I'm disappointed that the trail is coming to an end, but looking forward to the adventures ahead. The huge granite domes and cliff faces of the Saguenay Fjord are spectacular from any vantage point. but there's a particularly intimate way to experience them. And that's through a Via Ferrata in La Baie Eternité. This Via Ferrata is consistently ranked in the top 10 in the world.
So how far away is the actual the wall where we're starting?
It's pretty close. It's just over there.
Oh, okay, great.
Okay, Eric, here we are.
Let's get started.
Yeah, so I'm gonna go first.
Okay.
Here we have the section, they are different angle. Here we have a vertical, horizontal, and diagonal. So on vertical way, we're gonna secure yourself directly into the rung. And that way, I'm ready to climb it up. So just move 1 foot, move one carabiner, 1 foot, one carabiner. And do it again and again. Always make sure you have one carabiner higher than your hips when you're on vertical. And when the cable come back horizontal or got an angle on it, we clip directly into it.
So the vertical sections you clip to the rungs, the horizontal sections you clip to the cable.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just getting started here on the Via Ferrata du Géant with Jordan here. Just getting out of the trees, getting my first glimpse of the fjord and the Bay of Eternity. It's spectacular out here.
This is pretty dope. Looking out. I like that.
Oh yeah, this is cool. So we've made it about halfway through the Via Ferrata so far. The temperature is totally changing, clouds are coming in, and it got cold, but we still have a long ways to go. We're just about to cross this chasm feature, and there's a really sweet bridge that makes the gap, so I'm really looking forward to that. This looks tricky. Practice my inner trapeze artist here, or tightrope walker. This is pretty cool. This is some of the most beautiful stuff I've ever seen. And just doing this Via Ferrata with Jordan, this is definitely the most intense and intimidating Via Ferrata I've ever done. It's got the most exposure I've ever seen on a Via Ferrata. And it's definitely like right up my alley. I'm loving it. This is so fun.
Hey!
You made it so far.
Yeah. So this is the top.
Yeah, we were starting just over there.
Yeah.
All the way.
Yeah.
Climb up.
That's a big rock face we just came up.
Yeah.
Well, that was a spectacular day. Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Fantastic experience up here.
Yeah, it was.